Gurunji Senior Secondary School, CBSE, Namakkal.
Successful, result-producing school in state every year.
Administered by the Board of Directors with over 35 years of experience in the teaching field.
Special attention on art, craft, music, dance, silambam, yoga, skating and karate.
Focus on Hindi Sabha and Spell Bee Olympiad exams.
Smart class for effective and innovative learning and well-furnished library.
Solitary importance on sports and games in state and national level.
WhatsApp facilities to know activities of students and school inside the campus.
NEET, JEE, IIT coaching experts from Rajasthan and Andhra Pradesh along with our effective teachers.
Admission registration for classes LKG to plus 2.
Kurunji Educational Institution, Kavetipatti, Namakkal. Admission in progress. CBSE, KG to 12, contact 9025895176. Metric 6 to 12, contact 9344567484. For online admission, log on to www.kurunjischoolnkl.in.
Hello students, now we are discussing applications of derivatives, miscellaneous exercise. Up to question number 5 we discussed. Next question number 6, find the intervals in which the function f of x equal to 4 sin x minus 2x minus x cos x upon 2 plus cos x is increasing and decreasing. In which interval this function is increasing and in which interval function is decreasing. Okay, how to find? Now we will find f dash of x. Wherever f dash of x is positive, in that interval f of x is increasing. Wherever f dash of x is negative, in that interval f of x is decreasing. Okay, now what is f of x given? F of x is given as 4 sin x minus 2x minus x cos x upon 2 plus cos x. Now from these two terms in numerator, minus 2x minus x cos x, from these two I will take minus x common. So what we get? 4 sin x minus x into 2 plus cos x upon 2 plus cos x. Okay. So what we can write here, f of x is equal to 4 sin x upon 2 plus cos x minus x into 2 plus cos x upon 2 plus cos x. So 2 plus cos x, 2 plus cos x cancel. So what we get, f of x equal to 4 sin x upon 2 plus cos x minus x. Okay. F of x equal to 4 sin x upon 2 plus cos x minus x. Now f dash of x. F dash of x, here minus x derivative minus 1, okay, minus 1. Now here numerator 4 common, 4 I will write outside, 4 into sin x upon 2 plus cos x. Sin x upon 2 plus cos x, it is u by v form. U by v derivative is what? V into u dash minus u into v dash upon v square, okay. So u is sin x, v is 2 plus cos x. So denominator v square 2 plus cos x whole square, numerator 2 plus cos x into sin x derivative is cos x minus numerator, that is sin x into derivative of denominator, derivative of 2 plus cos x, 2 derivative 0, cos x derivative minus sin x. Okay, so what we have, 4 into, if you multiply 2 inside here, 2 cos x plus cos square x, now minus sin x into minus sin x, plus sin square x, okay, upon denominator 2 plus cos x whole square, minus 1, this minus 1 as it is, okay, so 4 into, now here cos square x plus sin square x is how much, 1, so 1 plus 2 cos x upon 2 cos x whole square, if you multiply with 4, 2 cos x into 4, 8 cos x plus 1 into 4, 4 upon 2 cos x, 2 plus cos x whole square minus 1. Okay, now if you take LCM, LCM is how much? 2 plus cos x whole square. So this term as it is, 8 cos x plus 4 minus half 2 plus cos x whole square. Okay, so denominator 2 plus cos x whole square, numerator 8 cos x plus 4 minus half a plus b whole square. A plus b whole square is a square plus b square plus 2ab. So 2 square 4. Multiplying minus, so minus 4 plus cos square multiplied by minus, minus cos square plus 2ab plus 2 into cos x, nothing but 4 cos x multiplied by minus, minus 4 cos x upon 2 plus cos x whole square. Okay, now my plus 4 minus 4 cancel. Okay, so 8 cos x minus 4 cos x, 8 cos x minus 4 cos x is what? 4 cos x minus cos square x. Numerator f dash of x equal to 4 cos x minus cos square x upon 2 plus cos x whole square. 4 cos x minus cos square x upon 2 plus cos x whole square. So numerator cos x common. So cos x into 4 minus cos x upon 2 plus cos x whole square. Now this is f dash of x. Okay, what we got? F dash of x equal to cos x into 4 minus cos x upon 2 plus cos x whole square. Okay. Now f dash of x positive or negative depend on this part, no? What we know? Cos x range is minus 1 to plus 1. Cos x range is minus 1 to plus 1. So 4 minus cos x is always positive. 4 minus cos x is always positive. So also 2 plus cos x whole square. 2 plus cos x is always positive as cos x ranges from minus 1 to plus 1. 2 plus cos x ranges from 1 to 3. Its square is always positive. So denominator positive. Denominator purely positive. And numerator 4 minus cos x is also positive. So f dash of x positive or negative depend on cos x. Okay. So for increasing f dash of x positive, now f dash of x is positive whenever cos x is positive. Okay, f dash of x is positive when cos x is positive. Okay. Now cos x positive, f dash of x is positive when cos x is positive. Okay. Now cos x is positive in first and fourth quadrant. No? Cos x is positive in first and fourth quadrant. So f of x is increasing in the interval 0 to pi by 2 and 3 pi by 2 to 2 pi. Okay. Next, for decreasing, condition is what? F dash of x negative. So f dash of x negative, this is positive, this is positive. F dash of x is negative when cos x is less than 0. Cos x is less than 0. So cos x is negative in second and third quadrant. Cos x is negative in second and third quadrant. Okay. So f of x is decreasing in the interval pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2. Okay. F of x is decreasing in the interval pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2. Okay. So f of x is increasing in first and fourth quadrant, decreasing in second and third quadrant. Okay. Here question is f of x is given as 4 sin x minus 2x minus x cos x upon 2 plus cos x. So first of all, f of x what we can write by taking from these two terms x common. So 4 sin x minus x into 2 plus cos x upon 2 plus cos x. Now 4 sin x upon 2 plus cos x minus x into 2 plus cos x upon 2 plus cos x. 2 plus cos x, 2 plus cos x cancel. So f of x equal to what we get? 4 sin x upon 2 plus cos x minus x. Okay, this is f of x. Now 4 constant I'll write outside. Now f dash of x. This is u by v form. Minus x derivative minus 1. Okay, by applying u by v derivative. V u dash minus u v dash upon v square. After simplification, f dash of x equal to what we got? F dash of x equal to cos x into 4 minus cos x upon 2 plus cos x whole square. Okay. Now 4 minus cos x is always positive because cos x range is minus 1 to plus 1. So 4 minus cos x is always positive. Similarly, 2 plus cos x whole square is also positive. So 4 minus cos x positive, 2 plus cos x whole square is positive. So f dash of x positive or negative depend on cos x. Okay. Now for increasing f dash of x positive, f dash of x positive means what it has to be? Cos x has to be positive. Now cos x is positive in first and fourth quadrant. So f dash of x is positive in 0 to pi by 2 and 3 pi by 2 to 2 pi. So f of x is increasing in the interval 0 to pi by 2 and 3 pi by 2 to 2 pi. Okay. Now for decreasing f dash of x negative, f dash of x negative means cos x has to be negative. Now cos x is negative in second and third quadrant. So f of x is decreasing in the interval pi by 2 to 3 pi by 2. Okay. Next question, question number 7. Find the intervals in which the function f of x equal to x cube plus 1 by x cube is increasing and decreasing. In which interval it is increasing and in which interval it is decreasing. Okay. Now, What is f of x? F of x is x cube plus 1 by x cube. Its derivative f dash of x equal to x cube derivative is what? 3x square plus 1 by x cube derivative. 1 by x cube derivative is nothing but x power minus 3 derivative. X power minus 3 derivative is minus 3 into x power minus 4. Nothing but minus 3 by x power 4. So f dash of x equal to 3x square minus 3 by x power 4. Okay. Now for increasing, f of x is increasing if f dash of x is greater than or equal to 0. Okay. Now f of x is increasing if f dash of x is greater than or equal to 0. Now greater than or equal to 0 means this quantity has to be greater than or equal to 0. That is 3x square minus 3 by x power 4 is greater than or equal to 0. So write this term this side. So what we get? 3x square greater than or equal to 3 by x power 4. Okay. 3 cancel. So x power 4 comes to this side. So x power 6 is greater than or equal to 1. So x power 6 is greater than or equal to 1 means x lies between minus infinity to minus 1 union 1 to infinity. Okay. So x power 6 greater than or equal to 1 means x square whole cube greater than or equal to 1. So x square greater than or equal to 1 condition we have to write. Now x square greater than or equal to 1 means x belongs to minus infinity to minus 1 union 1 to infinity. Okay. Now second question, f of x is second part, f of x is decreasing if f dash of x is less than or equal to 0. Now f dash of x less than or equal to 0, what is f dash of x? 3x square minus 3 by x power 4 less than or equal to 0. So again what we get? Again we'll get it as x power 6 less than or equal to 1 condition, because if you write this term this side, cancelling 3 on both sides, cross multiply x power 6 this side, x power 4 this side. So what we'll get? X power 6 less than or equal to 1. Okay, x power 6 less than or equal to 1. Okay. Now x power 6 what we can write? X square whole cube less than or equal to 1. If you consider this as a t, t cube less than or equal to 1 means t less than or equal to 1. T less than or equal to 1 means x square less than or equal to 1. So x square less than or equal to 1 means x value lies between minus 1 to plus 1. So x square less than or equal to 1 means x square minus 1 less than or equal to 0. So x minus 1 into x plus 1 less than or equal to 0. So x belongs to minus 1 to plus 1. X belongs to minus 1 to plus 1. Okay. So here my question is in which interval f of x is increasing and in which interval f of x is decreasing. Okay. So f of x is x cube plus 1 by x cube. F dash of x is 3x square minus 3 by x power 4. For increasing, f dash of x has to be positive. So f dash of x greater than or equal to 0. So what we got? X power 6 greater than or equal to 1. So x power 6, what we can write? X square whole cube. So if you consider x square as t, t cube greater than or equal to 1 means t has to be greater than or equal to 1. Nothing but x square greater than or equal to 1. So x square greater than or equal to 1 means x belongs to minus infinity to minus 1 union 1 to infinity. Okay. Now for decreasing, f dash of x less than or equal to 0, that is x power 6 less than or equal to 1. So x power 6 less than or equal to 1, what we can write? X square whole cube less than or equal to 1. So x square less than or equal to 1 condition, x belongs to minus 1 to plus 1. So f of x is increasing in the interval minus infinity to minus 1 union 1 to infinity. F of x is decreasing in the interval minus 1 to 1. Okay. Next question. Find the maximum area of an isosceles triangle inscribed in an ellipse x square upon a square plus y square upon b square equal to 1 with its vertex at one end of the major axis. Vertex at one end of the major axis. Find maximum area of an isosceles triangle that can be inscribed in an ellipse x square upon a square plus y square upon b square equal to 1 with its vertex at one end of the major axis. Okay. Now suppose this is the ellipse x square upon a square plus y square upon b square equal to 1 with a greater than b, I'll consider horizontal ellipse. Okay. Now one end of the vertex of triangle is what? With its vertex at one end of major axis. Okay. Now major axis is x axis, a comma 0 and minus a comma 0 are endpoints of major axis. Now here what I'll consider, this is one vertex of the isosceles triangle. Okay. But now isosceles triangle, APQ is isosceles triangle, okay? Now this triangle symmetrical about x-axis, now whatever graph you have above x-axis, same graph you have above below x-axis also, okay? Now if you consider any point on parabola as A cos theta and B sin theta, okay? Now if you draw PM perpendicular to axis, PM perpendicular to axis and extend it to Q, so P and Q are the points on ellipse, okay? As it is isosceles triangle and PM is perpendicular to x-axis, PM is perpendicular to x-axis. Now here x-ordinate and here x-ordinate same, y-ordinate changes only by sine, okay? So if you consider P as A cos theta and B sin theta, Q will be A cos theta and minus B sin theta, okay? So P is equal to A cos theta, P is equal to A cos theta comma B sin theta, and Q is A cos theta comma minus B sin theta, okay? Now that is the information. Let equation of ellipse be x square upon a square plus y square upon b square is equal to 1. Then any point P on ellipse is A cos theta B sin theta. From P, drop a perpendicular on OX, that is major axis, PM perpendicular to OX, and produce it to meet to ellipse at Q, okay? So then triangle APQ is an isosceles triangle. The area of triangle is half into base into height, half into base into height, okay? Now if you observe, as it is A cos theta B sin theta, Q is A cos theta minus B sin theta. Now PM is perpendicular to x-axis, so here x-ordinate is same, no? at M, what is M here? M, vertex of M, coordinates of M are A cos theta comma 0, A cos theta comma 0, vertex M, okay, coordinates of point M are A cos theta comma 0, okay. Here OA is how much? OA length is A. So now area of the triangle APQ is equal to 2 times of area of the triangle AMP, okay? Area of the triangle APQ is equal to 2 times of area of the triangle AMP, okay? Area of the triangle AMP is half into what is base ma? PM and what is altitude? AM, okay? So 2 times, so area if you consider as S is equal to 2 into half into AM into MP, okay? Now here 2 and half cancel, so AM into MP. What is AM? AM, this length we need. So AM is nothing but OA plus OA minus OM, OA minus OM, where OA is how much? A, OM is M, OM is how much? A cos theta, so A minus A cos theta into MP, MP is how much? MP is B sin theta, okay? MP is B sin theta, okay? So here A common, so what we can write? AB into sin theta into 1 minus cos theta, so AB into sin theta into 1 minus cos theta, we multiply sin theta inside, so S is equal to AB into sin theta minus sin theta into cos theta. So AB is AB into sin theta minus, if you write 1 by 2 into 2, 1 by 2 into 2 sin theta cos theta is sin 2 theta, so 1 by 2 sin 2 theta. So AB into sin theta minus 1 by 2 sin 2 theta, okay? S is equal to AB into sin theta minus 1 by 2 sin theta. This is S, okay? Now ds by d theta is equal to AB constant, AB into sin theta derivative cos theta minus 1 by 2 into sin 2 theta derivative cos 2 theta into 2, so 2 into 1 by 2 cancel, so what will get? Minus cos 2 theta. So ds by d theta is equal to AB into cos theta minus cos 2 theta. Now second derivative, d square s by d theta square is equal to this part derivative, AB into cos theta derivative minus sin theta minus cos 2 theta derivative, cos 2 theta derivative minus sin 2 theta into 2. So minus half minus plus 2 sin 2 theta. So d square s by d theta square is equal to ab into minus sin theta plus 2 sin 2 theta. Okay, this is second derivative. Okay, d square s by d theta square is equal to ab into minus sin theta plus 2 sin 2 theta. Okay, now for minimum or maximum, first of all we'll put first derivative equal to 0. Now first derivative 0 means ab into cos theta minus cos 2 theta equal to 0. Ab non-zero means cos theta minus cos 2 theta is equal to 0. So cos theta minus cos 2 theta is equal to 0. So what we get, cos theta is equal to cos 2 theta. Cos theta is equal to cos 2 theta. But here we cannot cancel cos on both sides, right? 2 theta equal to theta, theta equal to 1, that is not correct. Okay. What we can write, ma? What we can write is as cos 2 theta is equal to cos theta. Cos theta, what we can write? Cos of 2 pi minus theta. So 2 theta is equal to 2 pi minus theta. So 3 theta is equal to 2 pi. Theta is equal to 2 pi by 3. Theta is equal to 2 pi by 3. But this is one critical point. Now area is maximum when theta equal to 2 pi by 3 if d square s by d theta square at theta equal to 2 pi by 3 is negative. I will check sin of d square s by d theta square at theta is equal to 2 pi by 3. Now what it is, d square s by d theta square is equal to ab into minus sin theta plus 2 sin 2 theta. So ab into minus sin theta is how much more, 2 pi by 3? Minus sin 2 pi by 3 plus 2 into sin 2 theta, 2 into 2 pi by 3 ma. So 2 sin 4 pi by 3. Okay. Now ab into minus sin 2 pi by 3 minus sin 2 pi by 3. 2 pi by 3, what we can add? Pi minus pi by 3. Plus 2 sin 4 pi by 3, what we can write? Pi plus pi by 3. Okay. Now sin pi minus pi by 3 sin pi by 3. Okay. So ab into this is minus. So minus sin pi by 3 plus 2 into sin pi plus pi by 3. In third quadrant sin is negative. So minus sin pi by 3. So minus 2 sin pi by 3. Sin pi by 3 value how much? Root 3 by 2. So minus root 3 by 2 minus 2 root 3 by 2. So minus root 3 by 2 minus 2 root 3 by 2 minus 3 root 3 by 2. So ab into minus 3 root 3 by 2. Okay. Now here ab positive, this is negative. So overall second derivative is negative. Okay. D square s by d theta square at theta is equal to 2 pi by 3 is negative. So by second derivative test, theta equal to 2 pi by 3 is a point of maxima. So area is maximum when theta is equal to 2 pi by 3. Area is maximum when theta is equal to 2 pi by 3. What is area? S is equal to what we have, ab sin theta minus sin theta into cos theta. So at theta is equal to 2 pi by 3. So S is equal to what? Ab into sin 2 pi by 3 minus sin 2 pi by 3 into cos 2 pi by 3. Okay. Ab sin 2 pi by 3. 2 pi by 3 what we can add? Pi minus pi by 3. So sin pi minus pi by 3 minus sin pi minus pi by 3 into cos pi minus pi by 3. Okay, sin pi by 3, sin pi by 3 value, sin pi by 3 value how much? Okay, sin pi minus pi by 3, sin pi by 3 minus sin pi minus pi by 3, sin pi by 3, cos pi minus pi by 3 is minus cos pi by 3, because in second quadrant cos is negative. Okay, so this minus of minus plus, no? So what we get, ab into sin pi by 3 value, root 3 by 2 plus sin pi by 3, root 3 by 2 into cos pi by 3, 1 by 2. So ab into root 3 by 2 plus root 3 by 4. If you take LCM, LCM is 4. So what we get, 2 root 3 plus root 3, nothing but 3 root 3 upon 4 AB square units. So maximum area, okay, maximum area of isosceles triangle is 3 root 3 by 4 AB square units. Okay, that is the answer, ma. So here question is, find maximum area of isosceles triangle inscribed in the ellipse with its one vertex at one end of major axis. Okay, one end of major axis if we consider as a comma 0. Okay, any point on the ellipse, okay, that is a cos theta, b sin theta. If you drop a perpendicular on major axis, let m be the point of intersection, coordinates of m are a cos theta comma 0. If you extend it, is it will be q a cos theta minus b sin theta. Okay, if you consider s as area of the triangle, so a p q then area of triangle APQ is equal to 2 times of area of triangle APM. Okay, so S is equal to 2 into area of triangle APM is half into base into height, half into base is MP and height is AM. Okay, 2 to cancel. AM, this length is nothing but OA minus OM. OA is A minus OM is A cos theta. Okay, A minus A cos theta. MP is what? B sin theta. Okay, now A common here, AB sin theta minus sin theta cos theta. So AB sin theta minus sin theta cos theta, we can write as 1 by 2 sin 2 theta. Okay, now ds by dt, d theta and d square s by d theta square we found. For minimum or maximum, we'll put first derivative equal to 0. By putting first derivative equal to 0, what we got? Theta equal to 2 pi by 3. Theta equal to 2 pi by 3. Now at 2 pi by 3, at theta equal to 2 pi by 3, second derivative we verify. Okay, second derivative what we got? Negative. Okay, second derivative is negative we got. So by second derivative test, theta equal to 2 pi by 3 is a point of maxima. So area is maximum when theta is equal to 2 pi by 3. Okay, so maximum area is equal to S is equal to in place of theta substitute 2 pi by 3. So what we got? S is equal to 3 root 3 by 4 AB square units. So maximum area of isosceles triangle is 3 root 3 by 4 AB square units. Okay, now we will conclude up to here. We will continue remaining problems in next class. Thank you.